I did, as Vicky was talking and trying to tease me, and you guys can get me a little bit too, but I had the pleasure of seeing what it is like to fly. This was an L-39 Albatross to fly in one of these beautiful machines. Watching Thunder over Louisville is always a rush, but flying in Thunder, well, that's a whole new level. Just ask Jay Gordon.
It's a lot of fun.
Jay has flown in Thunder more than 15 times in this L-39 Albatross, a Czech built jet that's used to train Eastern Bloc fighter pilots.
Who'd ever thought that a middle-aged American would be flying ex-Russian jets?
And who would have thought I would climb into one of these rocket ships myself?
We're not going upside down, are we?
I hope so. I certainly hope so.
Oh, my God.
You're not going to go Disney World night ride a ride.
But all right, I'm in.
I promise you.
Jay assured me I would love it.
It'll be fun. It'll be fun. Yeah.
You have a bag in there for me?
I do. A couple, actually.
As my whole family looked on, Jay and I taxied off to Bowman Field's longest runway and then took to the skies. We joined up with fellow Louisville pilot Lee Lee in his propeller-driven short Tucano. After a little formation flying, we made a solo break for higher altitude so Jay could give me a taste of what it's like to do aerobatics.
We did rolls, then we did four-point rolls, then we did inverted hangs.
At one point, I even flew the plane myself.
I don't know if you believe me or not, but I was like, I put my hands on the canopy like that. It's like, nope, you've got it. You're flying the airplane.
That was a lot of fun.
I never had to use the sick bags Jay tucked inside the cockpit for me, but let me put it this way. I never forgot where they were. It was a lot of fun, but I have to admit, I was pretty excited to get my feet back on the ground as well.
You're done.
We made it.
That was a lot of fun.
How fun is that?
Hair standing up.
Airplane still usable?
It takes some getting used to flying in a jet like this. And what I did was nothing compared to what Jay Gordon does in the plane during Thunder.
That was the kiddie version. When during the air show, tell us exactly what your routine will be. How difficult will you get?
Well, I will be pushing G loads about three times what we were doing today, and a much more violent feeling. What we did today was almost just gentle, ballet-ish.
You can't hear the folks on the ground roaring.
No.
What kind of a thrill do you get out of it? You know they're down there going nuts.
It's really interesting. At 6 mile, I think about the people. You know, I'm aware that there's a crowd down there. By the time I get to the box, I'm in my head. I mean, it doesn't matter who's there. I'm focused on that piece of river, and that's what I'm doing. So I really don't really even see it.
Oh, I got to tell you, that was a lot of fun. I was glad to be back on the ground. There you see the L-39 and Jay Gordon, and he's alongside his buddy in the Super Tucano, Lee Leet. What a tandem. These guys are from Louisville. I mean, they are just super class guys, and they're so excited to be a part of Thunder over Louisville. Jay told me that he gets a little nervous. He wears a golf glove on his hand. He says, you don't think about it, but, you know, you've got all the people down there in the banks, and it is a show.
Right.
And it is game time. Gets a little nervous. The hand gets a little sweaty.
They're both graduates of the U of L Engineering School, the Speed School. First flight was for the L-39 Albatross was in 1968. It's 40 feet long. It's a jet trainer. Guys, what did you think of Rick's first flight? I thought you did great.
I'm proud of Rick.
I think we need to open up an investigation of sick bag gate. I'm not so sure. His feet looked a little shaky once he got on the ground.
He had them. I knew it. I even got him out to test them. I had to swallow a couple of times because, you know, to you guys it's nothing.
How do you get used to that? It has to affect you that way. Doesn't it at first?
Well, when you go through pilot training, when you first start pilot training, that's probably the first hurdle that most people have to go through is you get airsick.
Oh, yes.
Or you'll get close to being airsick. Not everyone does, but that seems to be the biggest hurdle. And getting past that after your first few flights, if you feel like you're getting a little queasy, then you can basically, from then on, it's no big deal. I mean, once you get through that whole phase, and some people actually cannot make it through that, but...
it's quite the rite of passage. We actually have training chairs. They'll get and spin you if you're having problems and so forth, but I fortunately didn't have any problems, but I had lots of friends that came back looking awful green.
And I got to say, Rick, we're really proud of you because I don't think when I was flying the F-16, when I got to give incentive rides to enlisted people and other folks that would fly in the back seat, I don't think none of them ever made it through the flight without getting sick.
No, really?
So congratulations.
I'll second that. That was well done.
Well,